Yesterday, we gave you some recipes for a healthier Super Bowl party, but today we're going to look at the teams themselves. For us, joining us today is former NFL running back Brandon Bennett. He played for both the Cincinnati Bengals and the Carolina Panthers and played college ball at the University of South Carolina. And also joining us is a familiar face, former all-pro linebacker, Pittsburgh Steeler, Levon Kirkland, and he played college ball at the Clemson University, and he just happens to be my significant other. Welcome, both of you.
Thank you. We appreciate it.
Excellent. Well, we know that the Saints are looking to create history while the Colts are looking to repeat history. So which one of you want to talk first on what the teams need to do, establish which teams you're pulling for?
Okay, well, I'll go first. I'm thinking about the Colts and what they bring to the table. I think the first thing they bring to the table, which is very significant, is they're in the Super Bowl for the second time. And being in the Super Bowl one time myself 14 years ago, I think it's a big deal. Dallas was in the Super Bowl at the time. They had more experience, so they're a little bit more calm. I also think when you look at the coach, you got to look at Peyton Manning first. He's a guy who really orchestrates the offense, and he really gets them going. And the guy's very doable, and I think he knows the NFL defense is better than anybody else in the game.
Okay, good point. What about you, Mr. Bennett?
I'm loving the Saints. I think that they're a young team with, their whole state on their shoulders, you know, and everybody's for them and going for them. I think that they're peaking at the right time. You look at Reggie Bush. I'm very excited about the way that Reggie Bush has finally looked like a true running back for the NFL. And Drew Brees, the way that he's throwing the ball, he's not throwing any interceptions. The receiver's catching the ball. And Jeremy Shockey there and able to play this year, I think that's going to make a big difference. So I think it's going to be a good game.
So you think Reggie Bush is earning his money today, finally?
You know what? Finally. I think he is. You know, I'm telling you because I've been very, very disappointed
sure.
in him and, you know, the money level that he's making. He should have been, you know, but it takes some people some time. And I think that now these last couple games have showed that, you know, the type of player that he could be. And we already knew that he was electrifying, but now to be able to see him running a lot harder and doing things other than just running out of bounds, you know,
right.
I was excited about it.
And taking pictures.
Miss Kardashian, you know, we might need to put her on the team.
Well, speaking of Miss Kardashian, we've discussed this here as a joke, but who do you think is going to get more FaceTime, Kim Kardashian or Archie Manning?
Kim Kardashian.
Really?
I think so.
Oh, my. What do you think?
I think the old man is going to get more attention. I think they're going to show him at least seven times.
Seven times. Wow.
Yeah. Well, you know, if he throws an interception, they'll show him.
Right.
If they throw a touchdown, they'll show him. They're going to show him before the game starts.
Sure.
I mean, so they're going to show him a bunch of times.
Well, basically. But see, I think that when they showed Kardashian, Miss Kardashian, Reggie Bush kept doing good. You know,
right.
He flexed the muscles. He was running hard.
Right,
he made some nice plays, and they kept showing her, you know. So I think that might be his inspiration if she's out.
Right. I think the four times for her, but I think it's going to be over seven times for the Peyton family.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, that's the official prediction. Kim Kardashian, seven times?
Four times.
And Archie Manning, seven times.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. That's fine.
Right.
Now let's get back to the game.
Okay.
Some analysts are concerned about injuries now, and Indianapolis Colts have Freeney injured and Reggie Wayne.
Right.
What do you think about that?
Well, you know, I'm not so worried about the receivers with Reggie Wayne because they got Pierre Garçon, Austin Collie, Dallas Clark. So they got some weapons that they can move the ball around, and they don't really need Reggie Wayne. Matter of fact, I don't think Reggie Wayne was really a big factor in the last game. Now, Freeney, on the other hand, I think is going to be a big factor because he brings a pass rush. He brings something dynamic to the team, and I think they're going to miss that. You know, they're saying that he's going to play. Mm-hmm. Of course he's going to play. It's a Super Bowl.
Right.
Right.
I mean, if you had a bullet in your leg, but I think with him, he's
sure.
not going to be as effective as he always is. And I think that's going to be a problem for the Colts.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
What about for the Saints? Any significant injuries?
No, I don't think we have any significant ones or whatever. I think we're looking mostly at hoping Freeney doesn't play. Because the thing is, as long as Drew Brees can sit back there and just pick his players or whatever, we can make plays.
Okay.
You know, so.
Sounds good. Well, I tell you what, we'll be right back with more information on Super Bowl 44.